الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, dear sisters, alhamdulillah, we just finished Salat al-Fajr, jama'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it in our hasanat. Allahumma amin ya rabbal alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it in our hasanat. Allahumma amin ya arhamar rahimin. Three things that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam feared for his nation or his ummah or his followers alayhi salatu wa sallam. That's why sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he warned us from these bad things. Number one, he was talking about al-riya. Riya, al-shirk, al-asghar, the minor shirk. Number two, he was warning us about also our tongue. Don't be careful when you use your tongue, because there are too many ways, subhanAllah, the tongue. Most of people go to Jahannam because of their tongues. This is what Rasulullah said. Also, he warned us from the dunya, how this dunya will be open for you and a lot of things are going to come to you. And might be you will be occupied, your heart, and subhanAllah, physically and spiritually, you're going to be occupied with this dunya, alhaakum al-takathur, like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. طيب هنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم because he loves us, he is warning us from these things. Whatever good, he used to tell us about it. Whatever bad, he used to warn us صلى الله عليه وسلم because he loves us صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he never hides anything from us عليه الصلاة والسلام. Me, I said, جمعة, I have my own privacy. You have your own privacy. You never tell even sometimes maybe your spouse about it. Everybody has his own privacy. But Rasulullah, one of the Sahaba said, كان يعلمنا صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى الخراء عليه الصلاة والسلام. He used to teach us even what to do in the bathroom. He never hide anything. His life was like open book for us عليه الصلاة والسلام. Because he's Rasulullah. He's مبلغ عن الله. He used to deliver the message عليه الصلاة والسلام. There is no secret. Even during the special time with his wives, our mothers, like Aisha, they used to mention all of that openly to us. How we used to take shower with her. How we used to make intercourse. Even that, we knew about it. To learn from him, alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah mentioned that in the last ayah, in Surah Al-Tawbah, verse 128. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ Or another recitation. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ قرأت الدوري السوسي أبو عمر. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ Another qira said, مِنْ أَنفَسِكُمْ He's one of the best. And he's one of those who are amongst you. مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عزيز عليه ما عنتم will be so sad when you will be stubborn and not listening to him. حريص عليكم because he is حريص عليكم. He loves you. بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. This is out of his رحمة to the مؤمنين and kindness صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's why النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم any way is to see that way will save us from جهنم and save us from the hardship of this dunya and the bad things he used to warn us عليه السلام be away from that. صلى الله عليه وسلم said في حديث narrated by Imam Ahmad محمود بن لبيد said صلى الله عليه وسلم says إن أخوف ما أخاف عليكم الشرك الأصغر اسمه إن قالوا يا رسول الله وما الشرك الأصغر قال الرياء he said the most really I feared just for you he said the shirk الأصغر the minor shirk what they said يا رسول قال الرياء الرياء means what comes from the vision showing off you want people to look at you this is the رياء when you make صدقة when you make prayer and you make that and the shirk has two types الشرك الأكبر If you sit partner with Allah, you worship others beside Allah, this will take you out from Islam. Shirk al-Akbar. Shirk al-Asghar has two types. Shirk Zahir. Shirk Zahir means people can see that the way you talk, the way you believe, the way you act, الأفعال والأقوال والاعتقادات. والشرك الخفي, shirk that's hidden. Shirk الرياء. Hidden shirk means you're coming to the masjid. I want to give sadaqah. I can go to the box. I can go to it secretly. But no, no, Sheikh, I have sadaqah for the masjid. According to your intention now, might be you want to urge others to do like you, but especially when make ask for sadaqah, or just showing off. I am the one who give the more, the most or something. When you come, for example, to the salah, I show people how you are khushu' and because if you pray alone, you will not do the same because nobody going to see you. This is called shirk al-khafi, the hidden shirk. For this is also so dangerous. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَلَا أُخْبِرُكُمْ بِمَا هُوَ أَخْوَفُ عَلَيْكُمْ عِنْدِي مِنَ الْمَسِيخِ الدَّجَّالِ. Something really so dangerous, even more than Masih al-Dajjal, the false Messiah. They said, بَلَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ تِلَسْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. He said, الشِّرْكُ الْخَفِي, that hidden shirk, which is the riyah, showing off. طيب, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes those who are showing off, this people of riyah. الَّذِينَ هُمْ يُرَاءُونَ وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَعُونَ. It's in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this kind of people, they are denying Islam. أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يُكَذِّبُ بِالدِّينِ. Look at the beginning of the ayah. فذلك الذي يدع اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم الذين هم يراؤون ويمنعون المعون. يراؤون, just I'm doing that for the sake of you. And Allah asked us in the Quran to worship him with sincerity. قال وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين حنفاء ويقيموا الصلاة ويؤتوا الزكاة وذلك دين القيم. Allah commanded us to worship him with sincerity and to establish salah and to give zakah. And this is in Islam. وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ. فَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى telling us, be careful, be careful, be careful. That kind of shirk also, as I said, the first three people from the ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to سَعَّرْ بِهِمُ النَّارِ, they will go to hellfire. عالم, a scholar, or قارئ قرآن, somebody reciting Quran. Second, مجاهد, not في سبيل الله, مجاهد, he was fighting, and the fighting with the Muslims. The third one, somebody should give money. Allah will ask you, what did you do with my ni'mah? Say, Ya Rab, oh, I teach Quran, I'm scholar, and they said, كذبت, you're a liar. Second one, I gave money, كذبت, you're a liar. The third one, I was fighting في سبيل الله, كذبت, you're a liar. And Allah will give order to the angels to drag them, three of them, on their faces to the hellfire. Why? Because they used to do all that. And you teach, ليقال عالم, people to be seen. People will say he's a scholar, he's a qari. Too many followers in YouTube, too many followers in social media. I like that people that are pointing at him. His niyyah or his intention, Allah knows about it. That's why you're a liar. Already they said about you. Already they talk highly about you. You take already your reward from them. And you was fighting because you want people to see you how you're champion and you're strong. And not because for the sake of Allah. And you give money to be shown to be seen. People say he's generous. People, they talk highly about you. See, not for the sake of Allah. That's why shirk al-khafi, that's a very hidden shirk. Be careful. يعني, you have to count yourself. طيب, how to, if you have this problem, how to solve this problem? First of all, sincerity. Second, عظم الله في قلبك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so great. If you feel that and you believe that Allah is so great, everything else or anything else will be minor like this, small in your heart. And you have to know that nobody can benefit or harm you. Why you look at them? Why you seek their pleasure? Only to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, you have to give up anything in the hand of people. Just to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you do that, subhanAllah, you will be safe from that kind of shirk. Allah, sincerity, that's all. Number two, as we said, al-lisan, your tongue. Most of people will go to hellfire because of their tongues. And who said that? Rasulullah sallallahu was holding his tongue and he was talking to Mu'adh ibn Jabal. قال وَهَلْ يُكَبُّ النَّاسُ عَلَى مَنَاخِرِهِمْ فِي جَهَنَّمْ إِلَّا مِنْ حَصَائِدَ أَلْسِنَتِهِمْ. Another hadith said, وَهَلْ يَكُبُّ النَّاسَ عَلَى مَنَاخِرِهِمْ فِي جَهَنَّمْ إِلَّا حَصَائِدُ أَلْسِنَتِهِمْ. Most of you will go to hellfire because of this tongue, subhanAllah. It's a small muscle like this, and most of you will take all the body to Jahannam. That's why every day the body was talking to the tongue, اتَّقِ اللَّهِ فِينَا فَإِنَّمَا نَحْنُ بِكَ فَإِذَا اسْتَقَمْتَ اسْتَقَمْنَا وَإِذَا عُجَجْتَ عُجَجْنَا. Your body is talking to the tongue every morning, every day. Fear Allah on us. If you will be good, we will be good. If you will be kharban, we're going to be kharban like you. That's it. That's why the tongue will lead people to Jahannam, wal-'azhu billah. And most of the sin of the son of Adam because of their tongue.
عند الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم ده سلونج حديث. He said ده حديث من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. If you really believe in Allah's oneness and the hereafter, say something good or it's better be quiet. This. And the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث عقبة بن عامر he said يا رسول من نجاه how can be survive how can be saved from this he said أمسك عليك لسانك hold your tongue وليسعك بيتك وليسعك بيتك وليسعك بيتك stay home if you don't have anything to do outside don't deal with people too much because it's a lot of fitna وابكى على خطيئتك you know make دعاء and just be busy with what will benefit you and this is what رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said. And Rasulullah sallam he warned us also from the dunya. He said, "Hey, Abu Ubaidah, Amr ibn Jarrah, who went to Bahrain to get some booty of the war, and they break Salat al-Fajr like what just we did right now. He just arrived, and people they were so happy, oh, smiling, oh, we get money, booty of the war, we have this, they're gonna be distributed." And Rasulullah sallam said, "Wallahi, ma akhsha alaykum al-faqr. I never feared poverty for you." But the problem is, what I really care about, dunya, it will be open for you. And you're going to compete with each other in it. And you will be destroyed like the people before you, Bani Israel. They've been destroyed because they're loved with dunya too. For dunya, yes, you know, Quran said too many ayat and the hadith of Rasulullah sallam. Dunya like a dead goat or dog or something, Rasulullah. They goat. He saw a dead goat and he said, oh, how much guys if I say, want to sell this to you how much you want? They said Rasulullah it's a dead filthy and also its ears is so short you know a sick he said wallahi dunya ahwal عند الله من هذه this is the dunya for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not even this maybe has value dunya has no value for that's why the problem of the people nowadays is dunya that's why they are not coming to salat al-fajr or salat al-isha or salawat in the masjid or they are you did not see them often just maybe in the Eid or Jum'ah or Ramadan in the masjid because they've been occupied with dunya they want to collect more that's why they will be busy more they will be occupied more they don't have time more to Allah Azza wa Jal that's why this is a boring they work hard and the dunya just you need time you need effort you need too much thing to collect money you are in business and you have to work for it that's why they have no balance in these people they have no balance at all They never balance between the dunya and the akhirah. And the dunya, just put it in your hand and use it for the akhirah. This is the main point. When أراد الآخرة وسعى لها سعيها وهو مؤمن فأولئك كان سعيهم مشكور. Yes, Allah will appreciate your work if you work for the akhirah. But the dunya, Allah will give you according to your عمل or whatever you do. This Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said three things. He warned us from that. And this ayah, Surah Al-Hadid, I recited yesterday. اعلموا انما الحياه الدنيا لعب ولهو وزينه وتفاخر بينكم وتكاثر في الاموال والاولاد كمثل غيث اعجب الكفار نباته ثم يهيج فتراه مصفرا ثم يكون حطاما وفي الاخره عذاب شديد ومغفره من الله ورضوان وما الحياه الدنيا الا متاع الغرور الدنيا is متاع الغرور has nothing has no value بس we have to be careful because الغرور which is الشيطان الشيطان الغرور الشيطان متاع الغرور most people will be deceived by this dunya I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all amongst the children of الآخرة not the dunya آمين يا رب العالمين ربنا تقبل منا واغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا يا رب العالمين نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وأجله ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وأجله يا ربنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم يا رب احفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعلى أيماننا وعن شمالنا واجعلنا لك من الشاكرين اللهم يا رب العالمين اهد قلوبنا للإسلام وثبتنا على الإيمان يا رب العالمين واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن كان له حق علينا يا أرحم الراحمين واشف من كان منا مريضا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين واهدي أبنائنا يا رب العالمين لما فيه الصلاح والفلاح لهم ولنا في الدنيا والآخرة يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم جزاكم الله خير وإياكم إن شاء الله